Andariki Namaskaram. Honorable Chairman, Telangana State Legislative Council, Honorable Speaker, Telangana State Legislative Assembly, Honorable Members of Legislative Council and Legislative Assembly, I convey my heartiest greetings. The Telangana State marching with an objective of development of all the sectors and welfare of all the communities is treading forward with self-confidence into yet another financial year. Telangana region was carved into separate states as a new dawn, ushering from utter darkness by tearing apart the darkness that prevailed for 6 decades. Telangana state, which is still a nascent stage, had achieved many milestones in all sectors and became a torchbearer to the entire country, just as blossoming flower sheds its fragrance. Those who opposed formation of Telangana hurled several curses like there will be a law and order problem. If Telangana state is formed, utter jeopardy will prevail in Hyderabad. Darkness will exist without power and industries will move away. They even made mockery that people of Telangana are not capable of doing agriculture. They prophesized that Telangana would not survive as a state. Even after formation of Telangana also, the external and the internal elements had even tried to halt the progress of the state with their plots. But what happened? The way shown by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, that only answer to the opponents is to stand straight by facing challenges and to take our identity to a state which cannot be put aside, is taken as an inspiration, and Telangana state today is standing straight and made critics to shut their mouth. Under the visionary leadership of Chief Minister Kalvakuntla Chandrasekhar Rao, several innovative schemes were introduced by government which paved the already shattered Telangana state due to the plots of erstwhile rulers into the development mode and transformed Telangana as a progressive state. The rise of Telangana state to third position is in Sustainable Development Goals India Index declared by UNO reflects the state's progress. The remnants, the achievements from 2014 June 2 till today, we will be left astonished. If we recollect the awful memories of distress prior to the formation of the new state, even now those memories will pain us. Then there was backwardness in all sectors, unrest in all sections of community, disturbance in all regions, darkness everywhere, and was a zigzag puzzle. From these dire straits, Telangana state reached to stage of optimism is not a miracle that happened in overnight. Behind this victory lie thousands of hours of brainstorming and endeavoring for 6.5 years in matter concerning what should happen in Telangana after the formation of new state. The then leader of movement and at present the leader of our state, Sri Kalvakuntla Chandrasekhar Rao, had crystal clear understanding in the background of his experience. Government had comprehensive understanding as to what is there in Telangana, what did it lack, what was necessary, where do we stand in different sectors, where we should head, what are immediate necessities, what are future goals, what are the resources available and how to utilize them, how to pool the financial resources, what are the challenges we will be facing and how to overcome them, and took initial steps. End-to-end planning and perfect execution only placed Telangana state in this high position. As a day goes, a good plan is success half done. This is not an exaggeration to say that the present, in present situations, the state are beyond comparison, and with that, the situation prevailed before formation of the state. Financial growth. The Telangana state formulated its development model as individual-centric and an objective to find solutions to problems. It formulated plans after assessing the available resources and the needs. With strict fiscal discipline, the state has been increasing the revenue resources from 2014 to 2019 with 17.24% average annual growth rate, the state had increased its revenues and stood first in the country. In 2013 to 2014, the state's GSDP was 4,51,580 crores, and it was by 2019 to 2020 increased by 114.71% to reach to 9,69,604 crores. In 2013 to 2014, as per capita income in Telangana was ₹1,12,162, and by 2019 to 2020 it was 2,28,216. The state government is spending the increased revenues with fiscal discipline and perfect planning to develop the infrastructure and welfare of the people. According to the present assessment, the anticipated per capita income and GSDP by the end of 2020 to 2021 financial year would likely to be 2,27,145 rupees and ₹9,78,373 crores respectively. From 2004 to 2014, in the 10 years in Telangana, ₹54,052 crores was spent as capital expenditure, whereas from 2014 to 2020, in 6 years, ₹2.3 lakh crores was spent as capital expenditure from both budget and non-budget funds. This alone reflects the state government's progressive and development-oriented fiscal management. Telangana state stood one among the top 5 states in the country with the best performance in increasing own resources. Taking loans within the limits of FRBM to increase the capital expenditure, this was mentioned in the state finance report, which was recently released by the PRS Legislative Research. This is an ample proof of the state's financial prudence and fiscal discipline. In 2019-20 financial year, the economic recession prevailed all over the country, coupled with 2020 to 2021 COVID-19 pandemic has an adverse impact on the state finances. But yet, the state government had evolved and implemented strategies to face each and every challenging situation and ensured that the state economy had not slipped out of hands.